Hello everyone. So today in this lecture we will study how to label a graph. So let's start now. So first of all, again what we have to do is we will be importing this library network x and we'll name it as nx. So it has been imported now, and then we will create an empty graph with the help of this nx dot. The name of that function is graph. So in this way we have created an empty graph whose information is stored in G. So if I write capital G, we can see that the graph has been created, and this is the graph which is available in NetworkX library, and this is the ID of the graph. Now after this, what we will do is we will create the nodes. So let's write G dot. To create a node, the function uses add underscore node, in which we will be passing the node. So in earlier examples, I have taken 1 and 2 here. But in this example, I will be taking ABCD. Generally, we represent it that way also. So I will be taking A and B. And in this case, you can see that there is no labeling given to these nodes. We don't know what is the name of this node. So in this video we will learn how to give a label to the node basically. So the first node that we are creating is, let's say I'm creating node A, and again copy this and I create another node, that is B, right? So two nodes have been created with name A and B. Now after this we will create an edge between these two nodes A and B, and for that we have another function, that is add underscore edge, right? As I have discussed in the earlier lecture, that see, when we are creating a node there, because we, this function will be creating only one node, that's why we are passing only one input parameter. But in case of add edge, basically when we have to create an edge will be created between two nodes. Obviously this is the basic definition. So if we have to create the edge between two nodes, so here the input parameters will be two, not one. So the way, this is the basic difference between these two functions. And what are the nodes between which we have to create the edge? That is A. So let's copy this. And let's copy it again. So let's copy this. And the another node is B. So edge has been created between both the nodes A and B. Now to see this information, whether the nodes and the edges have been created or not, we have another function that is called as draw. So again, that will be called with nx.draw. And in this earlier, what we used to do is we used to pass this G. Now we can see this graph. We can see this graph, see. So now we have seen that the edge has been created between the nodes A and B. Now let's see how the graph looks like. For that, we have a function in the network X, that is draw, in which we will be passing the graph name. So that is G. Now we can see that this particular graph has been created with two nodes and an edge between the two nodes, but we can't see the labels here. So this is same like that we have done in the last case, but now we have to provide the labels. For that we will be using with labels. So these with labels means the graph will be available with labels, and then for labels we'll be using true. So it means what? If you don't use this, by default it does not give labeling to the graph. But if we have to specifically label the graph, then we have to use this option with labels, which is available in this draw function. And for that, we have to make it capital. We have to make it true, in which the T should be capital. Now see what's the difference here. Now we can see that A and B now has been, these nodes, node 1 and node 2, A and B, are renamed as A and B. With labels, we can see that. Now see, the color is dark, so it's not that much visible. So let's study one more property of this draw function, in which we have node color. So we will give a color to the node. Let's say I give a light color to this. we can see that node A and node B are having yellow color and the node is named with this, right? Similarly, we can give any other color, and if we want to bold this labeling name, so what we will do is we have font weight as well. Font weight. Here we will write bold. And we can see that now this node name A and B is bold. And with this yellow color, we have given yellow color to this. So if I write false here, then what will happen? Labeling, see, node is there, their edge is there. This yellow color is also there. But this bold is specifically related to the name, node name. But because we have made it false, so we can't see the node names. And if node name will be there, then only we can see the bold option. So that is why these two functions have been disabled now. That is what I was saying, that if we use true specifically, then only we can see the labels. Otherwise, if we don't mention this, it is same like this. So now we have also understood that how we can basically create. See, every time what is happening, earlier it was like this. Now it is, in the first case, it was having this shape. Now after that, it changes shape to this side and now again to this side. Every time it is going to give you, means the shape of the graph is going to change, but basically the nodes will be there and an edge will be there between them. So this was all about, labeling the nodes in a graph. In the next lecture, what we will study is, we will be studying how to create a full-fledged graph by creating more and more number of nodes and more number of edges between the nodes. So I hope you liked it. So that's all for today. Thank you so much.